Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on steam turbine. So in this lecture, we are going to solve few more problems from the Anna University question paper and GATE question paper. And this is problem part 3. Example 1 from Anna University question paper, November 2014. A single row impulse turbine develops 132.4 kilowatts at a blade speed of 175 meters per second using 2 kg of steam per second. The steam leaves the nozzle at 400 meters per second. The velocity coefficient of the blade is 0.9. The steam leaves the turbine blade axially. Determine the nozzle angle, blade angle and at the entry and the exit, assuming there is no shock. So after reading the problem, we write down the given data. The power developed is 132.4 kilowatts. The blade speed is Vb equal to 175 meters per second. And the mass flow rate is 2 kilograms per second. The absolute velocity is 400 meters per second. The blade coefficient Vr2 by Vr1 equal to 0.9. And the velocity triangle of the impulse turbine is shown here. Inlet velocity triangle is shown here. Vw1 is the tangential velocity. V1 is the absolute velocity. Alpha is the nozzle angle. And Vb is the blade speed. And Vf1 is the flow velocity. Vr1 is the relative velocity. And theta is the blade angle at the inlet. And the tangential velocity at the inlet, so we have to calculate. And the from the power output, so power output equal to M into Vb into Vw1 plus Vw2. For axial discharge, Vw2 equal to 0. I show the velocity triangle for the axial discharge. So this is the velocity triangle for axial discharge. So the steam leaves with angle beta equal to 90 degrees. So, V2 equal to VF2 and VW2 becomes 0. That is what the condition for axial discharge. So, for axial discharge, so VW2 equal to 0, M into Vb into VW1 is the power. So, now the tangential velocity VW1 equal to power produced divided by M into Vb. So, 132.4 into 1000. So, kilowatt, it is given in kilowatts into 1000 divided by 2 into 175 equal to 378.2 meters per second. And from the inlet velocity triangle, so we calculate the nozzle angle. So look at the velocity triangle, we take cos alpha. Cos alpha equal to adjacent side, Vw1 by V1. So alpha equal to cos inverse of Vw1 by V1 equal to cos inverse of 378.2 divided by V1 equal to 400 meters per second equal to 19 degree. So nozzle angle alpha equal to 19 degree. And the Vf1 is V1 sin alpha, which is 400 into sin 19 equal to 130.2 meters per second. And the blade angle at the inlet, theta equal to tan inverse of Vf1 by Vw1 minus Vb, which is equal to tan inverse of 130.2 divided by 378.2 minus 175 equal to 32.6 degrees. And we calculate Vr1. So, referring to the inlet velocity triangle, we will calculate Vr1 equal to Vf1 by sin theta. So, which is 130.2 equal to 241.6 meters per second. And we are given velocity coefficient is 0.9. So, Vr2 equal to 0.9 times of Vr1, which is 0.9 into 241.6 equal to 217.4. Now, the exit velocity triangle is shown here. From the exit velocity triangle, the blade angle at the exit phi equal to cos inverse of Vb by Vr2, which is equal to cos inverse of 175 divided by 217.4 equal to 36.4 degrees. So, the answer to the problem, nozzle angle is 19 degree, blade angle at inlet is 32.6 degree, blade angle at exit is 36.4 degrees. These are all the answers. So, when you are good at the trigonometry of velocity triangle, you can easily solve the problem. So, for steam turbine problem, First, you write down the given data, then you draw the velocity triangle, inlet and the outlet velocity triangle. And you should be familiar with all the trigonometric relationship. So that we have given the practice in the classroom. So sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, sin alpha, cos alpha, tan alpha, everything you have to remember from the velocity triangle, not the general expression. The next question is from May 2016 question paper. A simple impulse turbine has one ring of moving blade running at 150 meters per second. The absolute velocity of the steam at the exit from the stages is 85 meters per second at an angle of 80 degree from the tangential direction. Blade velocity coefficient is 0.82 and the rate of steam flowing through the stage is 2.5 kilograms per second. If the blades are equiangular, so you have to remember equiangular blading, determine 1. Blade angles, 2. Nozzle angle, 3. Absolute velocity of the steam issuing from the nozzle, and 4. Axial thrust. So you write down the given data, VB equal to 150 meters per second, blade speed. Absolute velocity at the outlet of the stage, V2 equal to 85 meters per second and the corresponding angle is beta equal to 80 degree. The blade friction coefficient, velocity coefficient is K equal to 0.82 and mass flow rate is 2.5 kilograms per second. So, we draw the inlet velocity, exit velocity triangle. This is exit velocity triangle. So, the steam leaves, V2 is given here, V2 is 85 meters per second and beta is given as 80 degree and we have to calculate other parameters in the velocity triangle. So, from the outlet velocity triangle, we calculate VF2 equal to V2 sin beta, which is 85 into sin 80 equal to 83.71 meters per second. VW2 equal to V2 cos beta, which is equal to 85 into cos 80 equal to 14.76 meters per second. And the blade angle phi equal to tan inverse of VF2 divided by VB plus VW2. So, you have to take tan of phi. So, this is equal to, substituting the numerical values, tan inverse of 83.71 divided by 150 plus 14.76 equal to 26.9 degree. So, the blade angle at the outlet phi equal to 26.9 degrees. Now, we calculate VR2, which is VF2 by sin phi. So, equal to 83.71 divided by sin 26.9 equal to 185 meters per second. And this is the inlet velocity triangle. So, using the friction factor, VR1 equal to VR2 by K. So, 185 divided by 0.82 equal to 225.61 meters per second. Then we calculate from the inlet velocity triangle. So, theta equal to phi for the equiangular blading. So, that you have to remember. So, for symmetrical blading, equiangular blading, for impulse turbine, we have to use this condition, theta equal to phi. So, phi value already we have calculated, the same value we have to use for theta. Now, using the expression VF1 equal to VR1 into sin theta, which is 225.61 into sin 26.9 equal to 102.1 meters per second. And the VW1 minus VB equal to VR1 cos theta, then 225.61 plus cos 26.9 equal to 201.2 meters per second. Now, we calculate VW1 equal to VB plus 201.2, which is equal to 150 plus 201.2 equal to 352.2 meters per second. Now, nozzle angle alpha equal to tan inverse of VF1 by VW1. So, tan inverse of 102.1 divided by 352.2 equal to 16.2 meters per second. Now, we calculate the steam velocity at the inlet. So, V1 equal to VF1 by sin alpha, which is 102.1 divided by sin 16.2 equal to 366 meters per second. Then, we calculate the axial thrust. Axial thrust Fx equal to M into VF1 minus VF2. Substitute the numerical values, 2.5 into 102.1 minus 83.71 equal to 45.975 Newton. So, the answers to the problem. Blade angle is 26.9 degrees, nozzle angle is 16.2 degrees, absolute velocity of the steam issuing from the nozzle is 366 meters per second, axial thrust is 45.975 Newton. The question number 3 from the November 2019 question paper, a single stage steam turbine is supplied with the steam at the 5 bar and 200 degrees Celsius at a rate of 50 kg per minute. It expands into a condenser at a pressure of 0.2 bar. The blade speed is 400 meters per second. The nozzles are inclined at an angle of 20 degree to the plane of wheel, and the outlet blade angle is 30 degree. Neglecting the frictional losses determine the power developed, blade efficiency and stage efficiency. So the given data, P1 equal to 5 bar, T1 equal to 200 degree Celsius and P2 equal to 0.2 bar, blade velocity VB equal to 400 meters per second, mass flow rate is 50 kilograms per minute which is equal to 0.83 kilograms per second, nozzle angle alpha equal to 20 degree, blade angle at the outlet phi equal to 30 degree. And from the steam table, now the data we have to take from the steam table. From the steam table, at the pressure P1 equal to 5 bar, temperature T1 equal to 200 degree Celsius, we have to refer to the superheated steam table for enthalpy. H1 equal to 2855.1 kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific entropy of the superheated steam, S1 equal to 7.059 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And again, we have to refer to the steam table for saturated pressure condition, saturated steam. From steam table, from at 0.2 bar, P2 equal to 0.2 bar, HF2 equal to 251.5 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2358.4 kilojoules per kilogram, SF2 equal to 0.832 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 7.077 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And for isentropic process, so it is given in the problem, neglecting frictional losses. There is no friction. So the flow is isentropic in the nozzle, in the turbine, in the nozzle and the turbine. So for isentropic flow, S1 equal to S2. So S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. Substituting S1 equal to 7.059 equal to 0.832 into X2 into 7.077. So calculating X2 equal to 0.88. Now we calculate the specific enthalpy of the steam at the outlet condition. H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So 251.85 plus 0.88 into 2358.4 equal to 2326.89 kilojoules per kilogram. Enthalpy at the outlet is 2326.89 kilojoules per kilogram, and enthalpy at the inlet is 2851.1 kilojoules per kilogram. Now we calculate the velocity of the steam leaving the nozzle. So velocity of steam at the outlet of the nozzle, V1 equal to 2 into H1 minus H2. Which is square root of 2 into 2855.1 minus 2326.89 into 1000. So 1000 is to convert enthalpy from kilojoules per kg to joules per kilogram. So calculating the velocity at the outlet of the steam nozzle is 1027.8 meters per second. Now this is the inlet velocity triangle. So referring to the inlet velocity triangle, we calculate VW1 equal to V1 cos alpha 1. So 1027.8 into cos 20 equal to 965.8. VF1 equal to V1 sin alpha, so which is 1027.8 into sin 20 equal to 351.5 meters per second. And when calculate the blade angle theta, blade angle at inlet theta equal to tan inverse of VF1 by VW1 minus VB, which is tan inverse of 351.5 divided by 965.8 minus 400 equal to 31.8 degrees. So theta equal to 31.8 degrees. So we take the exit velocity triangle and we calculate VR1, relative velocity at the inlet from the inlet velocity triangle. VR1 equal to VF1 by sin theta, which is 351.5 divided by sin 31.8 equal to 667 meters per second. And the outlet velocity triangle is shown here. And for frictionless flow, it is given as frictionless flow, VR1 equal to VR2, which is 3667 meters per second. So we calculate the tangential velocity at the outlet, VW2 equal to VR2 cos phi minus VB, which is 667 into cos 30 minus 400 equal to 177.6 meters per second. So VW1 equal to 965.8 meters per second and VW2 equal to 177.6 meters per second. Now we calculate the power developed by the turbine. So W equal to M into VB into VW1 plus VW2, which is 0.83 into 400 into 965.8 plus 177.6 equal to 379.6 into 10 power 3 watts, which is 379.6 kilowatts. Then we calculate the blade efficiency. Eta B equal to 2 into VB into VW1 plus VW2 divided by V1 square, which is equal to 2 into 400 into 965.8 plus 177.6 divided by V1 square, 1027.8 square equal into 100 to get the value in percentage equal to 86.6%. And the stage efficiency equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2 divided by H1 minus H2. So, substituting the numerical values, 400 into 965.8 plus 177.6 divided by H1. 2855.1 minus 2326.89 into 1000 to convert the enthalpy into joules per kilogram. So, into 100 to get the value in percentage. So, equal to 86.6%. So, the stage efficiency and the blade efficiency are equal for the impulse turbine. The next question from the GATE question paper, GATE question paper 1994. For a single stage impulse turbine with a rotor diameter 2 meter and the speed is 3000 rpm when the nozzle angle is 20 degree, the optimum velocity of the steam. So, optimum velocity of the steam. So, there are 4 options given: 334 meters per second, 356 meters per second, 668 meters per second, 711 meters per second. So, we calculate first the VB, blade speed. VB equal to pi dN by 60. So, pi into 2 into 3000 divided by 60 equal to 314 meters per second. Optimum velocity of the steam. So, optimum blade speed ratio sigma equal to VB by V equal to cos alpha by 2. So, there is the optimum blade velocity coefficient. So, VB by V equal to cos alpha by 2 equal to cos 20 by 2 equal to 0.47. So, the optimum steam velocity V equal to 314 divided by 0.47 equal to 668 meters per second. So, the correct answer is 668 meters per second. Next question again from the GATE question paper 1997. The following data pertains to a single stage impulse turbine. Nozzle angle is 20 degree. Blade velocity is 200 meters per second. Relative steam velocity at the entry is 350 meters per second. Blade angle at inlet is 30 degree. Blade angle at exit is 25 degree. If the blade friction is neglected, the work done per kg of the steam. There are 4 options given: 124 kilojoules, 164 kilojoules, 169 kilojoules, 174 kilojoules. So, write down the given data. We are given alpha equal to 20 degree, blade velocity equal to 200 meters per second. For relative velocity of the entry, VR1 equal to VR2 for the frictionless flow, then which is 350 meters per second. Blade angle at inlet is 30 degree, or theta equal to 30 degree, and the phi equal to 25 degree. So, this is all the given data. So, the answer is 124 kilojoules. So, we will see how in the slide. So, we take the inlet and the exit velocity triangle. I have written the given data once again. Alpha, VB, VR1 equal to VR2, theta and phi. And we calculate cos theta plus cos phi. So, cos theta, referring to the inlet velocity triangle, cos theta equal to VW1 minus VB by VR1. And cos phi equal to VW2 plus VB by VR2. So, we know VR1 equal to VR2. So, cos 30 plus cos 25 on the left hand side equal to, denominator is the same, VR1. Numerator VW1 plus VW2, because minus VB plus VB getting cancelled. So, VW1 plus VW2 equal to 350 into 0.866 plus 0.906 equal to 620.2 meters per second. Now, the work done per kg of the steam, W equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2, which is 200 into 620.2 equal to 124,040 joules per kilogram or 124 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the answer. So, work done per kg of the steam equal to 124 kilojoules per kilogram. Next question again from the GATE question paper 2014. At inlet of an axial impulse turbine rotor, the blade linear speed is 25 meters per second. The magnitude of absolute velocity is 100 meters per second and the angle between them is 25 degree. Relative velocity remains the same between inlet and the outlet of the triangles are shown in the figure. The velocities are given in the figure. Assuming no losses, the specific work in kilojoules per kilogram is dash. So listen to the velocity triangle. The base is the blade speed and alpha is given as 25 degree, V1 equal to 100 meters per second. We redraw the velocity triangle with the proper notation. So this is the velocity triangle with the correct notation. And the red color line are extension. So the inlet velocity triangle. So VF1, V1 and this is inlet velocity triangle. And this is the outlet velocity triangle. So VF2, VW2 and this is V2 and VF2. And what is the condition given? So VR1 equal to VR2, 78 meters per second. VR1 equal to VR2. And for this condition, VR1 equal to VR2, for frictionless flow, there is no losses. VF1 is also VF2. So now, the length V, actually from here up to this point, it is VW1 and the remaining length is VW2. Now, we calculate VW1 equal to V1 cos alpha, which is 100 into cos 25 equal to 90.63 meters per second. VF1 equal to V1 sin alpha, which is 100 into sin 25 equal to 42.26 meters per second. For frictionless flow, VF1 equal to VF2 equal to 42.26 meters per second. Now we calculate. So VF1 equal to VF2, this value is also known. We take this right angle triangle. So connecting V2, VF2 and VW2. From the Pythagoras theorem, VW2 equal to square root of V2 square minus VF2 square. So square root of 58.6 square minus 42.26 square equal to 40.6 meters per second. So, VW2 equal to 40.6 meters per second. Then we calculate the work done. Work done equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2. So, 25 into 90.63 plus 40.6 equal to 3280, which is equal to 3.28 kilojoules per kg. That is the work done answer to the problem. Next question again from the gate question paper 1993. In a single stage single row impulse turbine, the steam entering with a velocity of 1200 meters per second with a nozzle angle of 20 degree leaving the blade in axial direction. The ratio of the blade velocity to the tangential velocity is 0.6. Ratio of blade velocity to the tangential velocity is 0.6. Sketch the velocity diagram and calculate the work output. So, write down the given data. We are given V1 equal to 1200 meters per second. Nozzle angle is 20 degree. So, axial discharge VW2 equal to 0. And we are given the ratio. Ratio of blade velocity to tangents. VB by VW1 equal to 0.6. So, the velocity triangle, inlet velocity triangle. And this is the exit velocity triangle for axial discharge. So, for axial discharge, V2 equal to VF2. VW2 equal to 0 and beta equal to 90 degree. Now we calculate from the inlet velocity triangle, VW1 equal to V1 cos alpha, which is 1200 into cos 20 equal to 1127.6 meters per second. And from the ratio, VB by VW1 equal to 0.6. So VB equal to 0.6 times of VW1, which is 0.6 into 1127.6 equal to 676.56 meters per second. And for work output, W equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2. So, for axial discharge, VW2 equal to 0. So, W equal to VB into VW, which is 676.56 into 1127.6 equal to 672 into 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. That is the answer. Or 672 kilowatts. That is the answer. And next question. From again, gate question paper 2000, a simple impulse turbine expands steam frictionlessly from 12 bar 250 degrees Celsius with an enthalpy of 2935 kilojoules per kilogram of to an enthalpy of 2584 kilojoules per kilogram at 0.1 bar. Assuming that the nozzle makes an angle of 20 degree with the blade motion and that the blade are symmetrical, so symmetrical blading theta equal to phi. Find the blade velocity that produces maximum efficiency for a turbine speed of 3600 revolutions per minute. Assume that the steam enters the nozzle with negligible velocity. So, you write down the given data. We are given P1 equal to 12 bar, T1 equal to 250 degrees Celsius, H1 is given 2935 kilojoules per kilogram, pressure P2 is given as 0.1 bar and enthalpy is also given H2 equal to 2584 kilojoules per kilogram. And we are given nozzle angle is 20 degree. Blades are symmetrical. So, theta equal to phi. So from the given data, we calculate the velocity of the steam at the outlet of the nozzle. So V equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, which is square root of 2 into 2935 minus 2584 into 1000 to convert enthalpy into joules per kilogram. So calculating the velocity of the steam at the outlet of the nozzle equal to 837.85 meters per second. For maximum efficiency, we have the blade coefficient. So sigma equal to Vb by V equal to cos alpha by 2. So cos 20 divided by 2 equal to 0.47, and we calculate the blade speed here. So blade speed equal to 0.47 into 837.85 equal to 393.8 meters per second. So the answer is 393.8 meters per second. That is what the question. You have to calculate blade velocity that produces maximum efficiency. So thank you for listening. So please revisit the video, note down the problems for your preparation towards the university examination. We'll stop here. We will meet in another lecture with additional problems on the steam turbine.